wish them the best of luck in this fair show jumping live competition.
Oh, that was mad. Oh. I have to go and get something to
Well, ladies and gentlemen, give her a round of applause. It is Anna Carvey and Clara Sella. Put your hands together, please, ladies and gentlemen. Don't hold back. Anna Carvey, Clara Sella. I see, unfortunately, it is at the end of the interest in this competition. Devon and Jenny Fisher, Fetch Audio, live competition. Well, Paul Murphy now, Excelsior Van den Noort. An honest partnership, they'll give 100% in their quest for a victory. And probably the biggest challenge in their history. It's a very fast one. Let's watch it, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Murphy, Excelsior Van den Noort. Second to go, it is the Ruby Redford. Last night, Devon is the Cheshire fans. It's a clear ride, 69.40 the time. Paul Murphy, Excelsior Van den Noort, 69.40, and a clear ride. So well done to that, Paul Murphy, Excelsior Van den Noort. Next we go to number three. Jenny Rankin now, Dental number three. That's who you're looking for, number three on the jersey. Very promising young horse, plenty of stride and jump. All of them is also very capable and a very competitive young professional. Jenny Rankin, Dental number three. Thank you. Well, just the four faults and fence eighth there for Jenny Rankin and Dental, four faults in time, 59.866. So let me just explain what you do that may have seen there. It's a wee bit confusing in the middle with the bell going. Fence nine is two fences, it's an alternative fence. So the riders can choose to jump the one on the left or the one on the right. Now the bell went because the one on the left fell over, and now our quarter time team of Peter Gillespie and Giorgio, they were out there, they getting up as quick as they could, but our judges thought they might not do it in time, so they had to get out there as quick as they can to put it up. Jenny Rankin, she decided to go anyway because she was going to jump the one on the right, and so therefore she carried on. But just in case you see that happening with the wind and the rain, that's what's happening, don't worry, it's, everything's under control. Our team here, top class international professionals, and we'll keep the things moving nice and swiftly. Number four is next. It's Olive Clark with captain's call, number four in the red jersey. They qualified in a very comfortable fifth place in Galway. Young horse, bench ride, piloted by one of Ireland's best lady riders. Olive Clark, captain's call, number four. Last night, 8 balls. And the last fence, the top part of the wall, just knocking a bit out. So where we finish on 12 falls there for Olive Clark, and captain's call 67.52. So they won't be qualifying for a winning round, but good to see them. Olive Clark, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Captain's call. Next we go to number 5. Alan O'Regan now, number 5, Electric Field. This lovely big grass arena here at Mullingar will suit this big striding horse absolutely perfectly. They're going to be very competitive in this competition, top of the game. Alan O'Regan, Electric Field, number 5. Well, it's 12 falls in total there. We had two fences falling and the refusal in the last. So it's 12 jumping falls, 75.97 at the time there. So we've had five combinations. We've only had the one clear round, just Paul Murphy, Excelsior, and Van Den Uyl. So they're sitting out in the lead at the moment. But they're clear at 69.40. We go now to number 6, Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle Forbes, Tina. It's a fast mare, plenty of jump, quick through and turn. She enjoys jumping off a sound grass surface, which this arena definitely is here at Mullingar 2015. Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle Forbes, Tina. A combination of two competitions at here at Mullingar International Horse Show last year. Big striding, smooth turning horse, loves the grass surface. The rider, very, very competitive man. Robin Hanson, first Rouge. Given the back hand, ladies and gentlemen, it's just the four falls there for Robert Harrison and first row 63.89. Sometimes the show jumping, you just have one fence, but it can be a really nice ride, but just one fence falls, and unfortunately we all have days like that. So it's four falls for Robert Harrison, first row 63.89, and they're tied. So just the one clear out in this section at the moment, going to Captain Thornton and Milano. We have three left to jump. The next rider is a very, one of the most experienced professionals, major player in Ireland. Former champion here at in Ireland, Francis Connors, with the Irish bred mare, Yusaki Diamond Lady, number 14. To be 71.06 in touch. Yeah, it's clear and Francis Connors, Yusaki Diamond Lady, 62.03 the time, annihilates the time of Catherine Thornton and Milano, 62.03 in clear. Francis Connors, former Irish Speed champion, is no wonder, 62.03 Francis Connors. Two left to go now, two left to go. Damien Griffin is next, Jatel number 15. Partnership competed successfully on the Western Circuit. Jatel get quite hot in a competition. Clear out of jumping, we will not be far away. Let's see how they go. Damien Griffin, Jatel number 15. Thank you. Well, that's a good time, 62-1-0, but we have four falls, Stefan, Griffin and Detel. So unfortunately that puts them out of contention in the Group B stage. One left to go, Francis Connors, you say he's out of the lady. They're on qualifying for the winning round at the moment, 62-0-3. One left to go, as I say. Number 16, Seamus Hayes and Twister. Fast horse, fast rider, with a good draw, and they've got that. They're last to go in this group. Consistent winning combination of both sand and grass surfaces. Certainly one of the favourites with our betting partners at paddypower.com and with the torch in the cafe. Seamus Hayes, Twister, last to go for Group B, the Noble Purple at Devonish Bet Show Jumping. Live competition. Seamus Hayes. Well, it's a total of 8-4 there for Seamus Hayes and Twister. 57.80 that time there. Very, very fast time, as someone just said. How did he do that? 57.80, 8 faults. Now, let me just have a wee look, because you might notice that Francis Connors, your second diamond lady, they are qualifier for the winning round of Group B, clear 62-0-3. If you put a bet on them, well done to you. Number 14 that takes Group B. But as I was just saying, you might have heard Seamus Hayes, Twister, they had a faster time, 57.80. Why are they not qualifying, you might say? Because it's not all about the time, because first and foremost, it's about jumping. It's about getting over the fences, keeping them clear. And so, Seamus Hayes, unfortunately, knocked a couple of fences there, fences 8, fences 9. That means it's 2 down and 8 falls. Even with the faster time, the 8 faults puts him out of contention. He needs that clear out if he was one to be Francis Connors. So it's not all about the time. The time is important, but it's the jumping ability that gets tested first and foremost over the set track set by our international course designer, Peter Gillespie, assisted by his team, assistant course designer, George Oak. So we go next to group number C. That's coming off in just a few minutes' time. It's time to get your bets in for the competition. 4:20 is the commencement of numbers 17-24. That is the Royal Blue section. Number 17 is Bentley Davidson. Number 18 is Captain Michael Kelly. Number 19 is Sven Hadley. Number 20, Roisin Fagan. 21 is Laura Madian. 22 is Jordan Coyle. 23 is Kenneth Graham. 24, Ethan Ahern. That is the 8 that come forward for Group C, the Royal Blue Group. Get your bets in, ladies and gentlemen. It's round about 5 minutes time, round about 5 minutes until the commencement of that section. So about 5 minutes time, get your bets in the paddypower.com forward slash bet show jumping, or head into the Marquee Cafe, where the tote system is running. Minimum stake of €5, the payout on the win only. Head in, tell the guys race number, horse number, and just state, and they will guide you through the entire process. The horse numbers are 17 through to 24. Race number, horse number, stake. That's all you need for your rates in for race number 3 coming up in 5 minutes. Oh, So last chance to get your bets in for Group C, the Royal Blue Group and the Divinish Bet Show, that being a live competition. We're just a couple of minutes away now, so last chance, get your bets in, go to the tote system in the marquee, in the cafe in the marquee, minimum stake at €5, go and tell them the race number, it's the race number 3 we've got coming up, tell them the horse number, numbers through 17 through to 24. And wherever your stake is, of course, the minimum €5. The payout is on the win only. But if you're not tired of the show, pop in, they'll be happy to help you. We'll guide you through everything for that. The riders, 17, Melody Davidson. 18, Captain Michael Kelly. is Sven Hardy. 20 is Roisin Fagan. 21 is Laura Mannion, 22 is Jordan Coyle, 23 is Kenneth Graham, 24 is Ethan Ahern. You may have noticed the way he line amongst you is we have number 17 Ed Davis coming in just to have a look about. That's absolutely fine, but we're not starting for just a minute or so yet, so still plenty of time to get those bets in to head into the marquee or onto the paddypower.com/bet-show-jumping. There's another slight twist to this Devonish Bet Show Jumping live competition. Local fashion designer Andrea Cullen and owner of the Wardrobe Boutique Mullin Carr and Siobhan Lynn have been scouting for the most stylish and appropriate dressed lady for the Style Stakes Takes a Turn competition. They're watching this group stages, they're watching all of the lady riders in the Devonish Bet Show Jumping live competition. And they have selected four stylist ladies. Carmela Wren from Waterford, Melanie Lynch from Mullingar, Imelda Camber from Tyrone, and Judith Farley from Galway. The finalists are all beautifully turned out, they tell me, and they're on the hill under the shelter of the log cabin. So hello, and we'll see you a little bit towards the end of our competition, and we'll find out who's winning and which one of our ladies is winning the Style Stakes Takes a Turn competition. Thank you very much to the Wardrobe Boutique of Mullingar for providing that prize. Well, we're just going to get fence 8 fits, and another one as well, because I don't think they're quite right for show jumping. I'm sure even the most inexperienced of you in the show jumping world will know that that's not quite right. So, expert team of Arena Party will get them thank you very much to them. They're all their fantastic. They come here, they work all the hours of the show. It's ridiculous. We start at 8:30 in the morning, we go to late into the evening, and they're here right the way through, helping out our international center, Peter Gillespie. So Melanie, we just have to fix a couple of fences. If you want, you can return to the pack, so we're going to have another couple of jumps. That's entirely up to you. We don't mind if you want to do that. But if you want, you can stay in. We don't mind. But if you want to take a couple of jumps, that's absolutely fine.
Where's that hot? Just there.
So we're just going to fix this fence, and then we'll have the Group C. So that's the Royal Blues. You can see Melanie with her red number 17 jersey, Royal Blue jersey. She's ready and ready to go. So we'll just fix these fences and then we'll do that.
So
we're just going to get fence 8, not quite in the same position, so we're just going to get that fixed. And the interest is doing this because even though they're in separate groups, they have to be absolutely fair to all of the riders in this Derby Special Jumping Live competition. So we're just going to get this fence put back to where it should be, so it's absolutely fair for all of our competitors in the Derby Special Jumping Live competition.
They just dropped the horses off back in the stable. They're just coming up. Coming up. That's what mum's in. She is that. That's what mum's in. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
So of course the time hasn't commenced yet. So bets are still open for this group. The time for the round hasn't commenced yet. So we're still getting get those last minute bets on. For the competition. Of course, Bethany doesn't close for the commencement of the timing for the first goal, that being Melody Hinton with Caspian.
Yes, good, isn't it?
That's number 17. It's an 8-year-old gelding. He placed a regular this year in the spring tour classes. He's fast across the ground. He's enjoyed by the open grass arena. Experienced rider in that major asset. Melody Davidson, Harry Caspian, number 17. First goal. In the Royal Blue Group, that's Group C, race at number 3 of the Nevis show jumping live competition. So we're just measuring. Height defences 1 meter 30, our course 19, just getting that sorted. We'll also start the web because this is a spread fence, we call that Oxer in the show jumping world. Basically means there's another pole behind the front part of the fence. And the horses have to jump that a little bit wider to get over to the other side. So we'll just make sure that's the right width, the right height.
I said, no. I said, I'm telling you. I said, we want you. No. This year I'm taking chilling.
So of course this competition is kind of sponsored by Dervish Nutrition. You can see there fence, that's fence number 11, the wall, the last fence in our course. Dervish Beyond Nutrition. Thank you very much, Nervish. Huge transfer for that winning round, €20,000, €10,000 go to our winner of the winning round. Of course, we've already had two qualifying for that winning round. From Group E, we had Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle Bob Cena number 6. For Group B, we had Francis Corners, Yusaki, Diamond Lady number 14. That's a bit of the qualifying so far. Let's go. Group C, it is race number 3. Melanie Davidson, Caspian, number 17. First to go in Group C. And see, the old gelding. It's going to be a good one. Melanie Davidson, a very experienced rider. Melanie Davidson, Caspian, 17.
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, the refuses us. We do have to say goodbye to Melanie Davidson and Casper. Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. It is a fantastic competition to get involved in. First time here at Mullingar 2015, Melanie Davidson and Casper.
But are you not clearing the one?
Captain Michael Kelly now, number 18. Valentine Lowell, number 18. Winner of three, just count them, 1, 2, 3 speed classes in the Spanish Tour this year. Fast, competitive combination. Never report that a fast target for later combinations in this group C. One for the shortlist, I told Captain Michael Kelly. Valentine Lowell, 18. Well, there's two fences falling, 8 falls here for Captain Michael Kelly and Valentine Lowell, 64.64 the time. And just remarking, it's probably the first time I think we've ever seen a member of the Irish Army in blue. Perhaps it'd be more appropriate if he was in the green, the emerald green coming up next. But anyway, Captain Michael Kelly, Valentine Lowell, 8 falls here. Well, next we go to number 19, that's Sven Hadley. Be ready to take Kasana. This may all have a good chance if she drops a clear right. She's fast, ridden by a rider who specialises in speed competition. Speed Sven, they call it. Sven Hadley, Kasana's next. 90.
Get you set up
straight.
Well, partially just not fair. Nick is on his team. Cassandra's a save. Nope, don't want to jump. Unfortunately, we all just sometimes that happens, and it's just not sparing into Cassandra's team. So we say goodbye to them from Group C. Next we go to number 20. It's Roisin Fagan. I can. It's an experienced horse, young rider, very competitive combination with the winning form on the grass. They're a local rider, Macy and Mungar, to be a very, very popular winner here. Roisin Fagan, I can, number 20. Well, it's 12 falls for Roisin Fagan, 12 for falls with Icon, 63.96 the time, 63.96, 12 falls. One is next. It's Laura Mannion. We're just going to get the arena party to check fence 8 for us, please. The fella on the bottom of fence 8. Thank you very much. So 21, Laura Mannion. Corvée Touchdown is next. They qualified at 4th place in Galway. Sebast Mayer, very economical on grass. Laura Mannion, Carby Touchdown, number 21. They are next to go in this Nemish Show Jumping Live competition. Thank you very much. So here we go, 21, Laura Mannion. Well, it's 8 falls there for Laura Mannion, Corby Touchdown, 68.32. Number 22 is next to go, Jordan Kyle. Amigo Van Herfinkenshoff said, Jordan Kyle, 22, on the jersey. Small horse with the big stride. Tries hard, it's quite quick to turn, and if it's clear jumping, it is certainly in contention or qualified. Just hang on a second for us, Jordan. Just hang a second. Fence 10, please, if we could fix that arena party. Fence 10, if we could just sort that Owen. Fence 13, so not in it, guys. If we could fix fence 10 first, please, so we can get Jordan Coyle underway. So Jordan Coyle, he's a young guy, but he's got plenty of experience despite his young age. It is certainly one to watch. We haven't had a clear round yet in Group C, so clear would be a very good place to be in this situation. So Jordan Coyle now, 22, Amigo Van Vegenshoff set, 22, Jordan Coyle. Peter Gillespie's roundabout, please. Peter Gillespie, our course set up. We could see you in the judges' box, please. Yeah, but it's clear. Clear round, the first clear round of Group C goes to Jordan Coyle and Amigo Van Vinkenshoff. The time there, 63.91 the time. Clear round. Next round, number 23, Birthday Boy Kenneth Graham. 21 today, he's one of the country's top speed writers with extensive international experience. Lenore Donatella, Kenneth Graham. Clear round for Kenneth Graham and Lanamore Donatella, 60.99 the time. That is our qualifying round with just one round to go. Birthday boy Kenneth, very, very happy at the moment. Happy birthday, Kenneth. Well, next to go is number 24, Ethan Ahern. Electric Chris, number 24. Ethan Ahern is faster qualified in second place at Galway. Good young professional rider in the saddle. Ethan Ahern, Electric Chris, 24, last to go in Group C. Thank you. just knocks the Sandrine Ishbian nutrition feds out. Four for Ethan Hernan. I don't want to make you sick, Ethan, but 59.30. The time was absolutely fantastic. But as I said earlier, jumping comes first, four falls, means that they don't qualify. So our qualifier is number 23, Kenneth Graham, Lennon Donatella. Shaping up to be a very, very good birthday for Kenneth Graham, because at the moment, he is actually the fastest of our qualifiers. So he's starting in pole position. Because I'll tell you what happens. When we get to our winning round, we will have four going into that. We've got three of them. We start in side one. And those four will start in reverse order of merit. They will start in reverse order of merit. So that's fault, and then any quality of fault, we look at the time and sort things out. So at the moment, starting first would be the qualifier from Group B. That's Francis Connors with Yusaki Diamond Lady, followed by Nicola Fitzgibbon, Catherine Foxina, and then our just seen Kenneth Graham, Lionel Donatella. They will start pole position at the moment. But we have one more space to fill. That's Group D. So last chance to get the bets in. We'll go with that just at 2 minutes time. 2 minutes time. Numbers 25, 27 through to 32. Number 26 is not running. So 25, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. Let me tell you who those riders are. 25, Dean Rogan. 27, Jessica Burke. 28, Susan Fitzpatrick. 29, Gerald O'Neill. 30, Dan Hopkins. 31, Jeremy Clark. 32, Kelsey Morgan. So we're underway in just a minute's time with the Group D. So number 25, Dean Rogan, is first to go with the guys and girls in emerald green. Dean Rogan, Prevent Van de Buxtail. Describes the horse as a real genuine mare, a triumph who almost gives you 100%. Dean, of course, fresh from his international debut at Balmoral and took second place in the Ravensdale Grand Prix. His confidence is very high, and so it should be. Fantastic rider, Dean Rogan, Craven Van de Buxtail, 25. It's a clear for Dean Hogan and Graveyard Vantage Bucks. TL6709. Good time. Clear ride to start off this fourth and final crew for the Devonish Special Jumping Live Competition. Next we have number 27. You'll see she has number 26 on her jersey, but that's because she's a little bit silly and Jessica Burks put the wrong one up. So I can show you it's 27. Vitesse and Jessica Burke, an experienced fast mare, very competitive rider, a little bit tipsy sometimes though. Good form on the same grass surface, will not lack assistance from the saddle. Jessica Burke, Vitesse, 27. It's a clear run for Jessica Burke and Vitesse, 60.14 the time. That's 7 seconds faster than Dean Hogan. Jessica Burke, Vitesse, they go into the lead at the moment. Now, Susan Fitzpatrick with Isaac Hartle, 28. An experienced mare just back to competition after a short layoff. Very impressive in the qualifier just yesterday. Wealth of experience upon a European Championship level. Susan Fitzpatrick comes next. Isaac Hartle, 28. Eight false there for Susan Fitzpatrick and Isaac Hartle, 61.99. But give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic rider took the individual gold medal at Pony European Championships back in 2013, if my memory corrects me. It's certainly going to be a fantastic rider on horses in the future. Susan Fitzpatrick, Isaac Hartle. Garrison Lux, ridden by Gerald O'Neill, is next, number 29. It's horse is not quite fully experienced at this level, but it's quick through its turn, and it's very, very good on the grass. experienced, ultra competitive international rider is Jared O'Neill, and he's really going to take this horse through its paces in this competition. Jared O'Neill, Cairns and Lux, 29. Well, we have 12 jumping falls. As I mentioned earlier, we have the time falls as well to look at. 87.40 is our time there. 86 is the time allowed. So, as I say, remember, it's one time fault for every 4 seconds, or part of 4 seconds, over the time allowed of 86 seconds. My math tells me one time fault there for Germany and Cairns and Lux. That brings them to a total of 13 at the end of group of the round in Group D. Now, in the lead at the moment, we have just the one clear in this Group D. Dean Rogan on Craver at Van de Buxtail. He's in the lead and qualifying at the moment in this Group D competition. And you may be wondering what happened to number 27, Jessica Burke Vitesse. They were eliminated from the competition because of a hat falling off before the end. They were eliminated. Dean Rogan is currently in the lead. Number 30, Dan Hawkins. Mr. Cruz is on track now, number 30. Well, Dan decided to save Mr. Cruz for another day. He retired from Group D from this Devon Special Jumping Live competition. Dan Hawkins here with Mr. Cruz retiring from competition. So we have just two left in Group D of the Devon Special Jumping Live competition. 31 and 32. That's who we have left to jump in Group D. Of course, thank you very much to our sponsors, Devonish Nutrition. They are fantastic people putting up the prize money. €20,000 is the prize fund, €10,000 going to our winner of the winning round. There's four going through. We know three, we've still to find one. So number 31 is next. That's Trevor Clark with Zanzibar the 5th. Poisson Specialist, that's coming up later on here in Mullingar, 6 o'clock for the Poisson Speed. It's a Poisson Specialist turned speed horse. Big shredding fast horse, you will enjoy the open spaces of this beautiful grass arena. Experienced professional rider will get the necessary assistance from the saddle. It is a very, very good contender. Jared Clark, Santa Barbara Fed, 31. It's clear, clear for Jared Clark and Zanzibar the fifth. 63.16 their time, 63.16. It's faster than Dean Rogan, so they're our qualifier with just one length to go. Jared Clark, Zanzibar the fifth, clear 63.16. So we have just one left to jump. It is the Emerald Green Group, the Group D. That's Catherine Morgan and George, number 32. It's a fast galloping horse with a quick turn. One other qualifier in County Life, and the Raider loves to have a real goal. So expect an action-packed finale to our group stages of the Devonish Best Show Jumping Live competition. It is Calvin Morgan, George, 32. Group stages, Group D of Devonish Bed Show Jumping Live Competition. Kelvin Morgan, George, 32. To qualify for the winning round and the chance of the 10,000 first prize, time needs to be faster than 63.16. Sixty-three, 37 is the time. That's four falls for Calvin Morgan and George. 63.37, four falls. So we'll have a short interval now, ladies and gentlemen, whilst we get set for the winning round. It is the final four. We'll bring you those final four in the order that they are going to be jumping in. We're just confirming it here at the judging box. We'll bring you that in just a second. It's the final four, it's the big one. It's the Devonish Bed Show Jumping Live Competition, the finale with a chance to win €10,000 to the winner. It's €5,000 to the second place, €3,000 to the third place, €2,000 to the fourth place rider. Big, big money here. It's Mullingar 2015. Don't go anywhere, we get set now for the winning round. of the Devonshire Nutrition Fit Show Jumping Live competition. Don't go anywhere. Well, we're just getting set for the final four now, the winning round here to the Devonshire Show Jumping live competition, Fit Show Jumping live competition. Now, you may have noticed our coach is then taking that moving fence at 6 lately. That's just because the ground's a wee bit cut out, so they just want to move it to ensure the best possible quality for our four winners from each round. Peter Gillespie, our international coach designer, ensuring the best possible conditions for the winning round.
Okay, could maybe turn that down a little bit for me, Craig, if you wouldn't mind putting the loud side. I have a very special lady, a very excited lady here. Her son is 21 today, but not just that, he's into the final. You must be excited, that Geraldine Graham, that's who it is.
Hello.
Tell me about Kenneth and come forward to the stage. You must be very excited.
Okay, I'm very proud and excited. Often he works terribly hard at home and, you know, it's the proof of the pudding coming out.
Were you watching through your fingers there, that?
Through my eyes.
Were you?
Yeah.
So do you get very nervous when Kenneth's jumping?
Extremely nervous. Extremely nervous.
And tell me, there's been a long trail. Kenneth's been with you now for, he's always stayed at home with you. You're his trainer as such. Do you get on well?
Very well, yes.
And tell me about the routine in the at the school and about your own riding school as well up there in Mough.
Hey, Kenneth works very, very hard. He's very dedicated and very, you know, he's a perfectionist.
And does he work in the riding school as well? Does he help you?
He does. He started recently because he's seen that he can earn a few pounds teaching. And money talks.
So you must be very excited, are you? And this is a huge competition. Devon Nash have been coming on board. They've been wonderful. They've been such a support here in Mullingar. And this is, must be the way forward. A lot to be. It has a huge future, this competition.
Yes, and we're very, very appreciative of Devon Nash. And we really, really hope that Robert Fagan makes it the best and everything. And this is a future competition.
So we'll all keep our fingers crossed for you, Geraldine, and happy birthday to him.
Well, let me just tell you the four that are coming into our winning right. They jump in reverse order of merit, but they start with a zero score, but they all went qualified with clear anyway. Number 31 was the slowest of all the qualifiers. He comes from Group D. That's Jerry Clark and Zanzibar the fifth, jumping clear with a time of 63.16. Number 14 will follow them from Group B. Francis Connors, Yusaki Diamond Lady, clear 62.03. Number 6 will be our third combination to join us. They qualified in Group A, and that's Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castleford's Tina, 61.09 their qualifying time. The only lady rider in this top four, I might add. Then to finish off, we have the birthday boy, Kenneth Graham, number 23, Lanamore Donatelli, 21 today. And this is shaping up to be a very, very happy birthday for him indeed. So we'll be underway with that in just a few moments time. It is the winning round of the Downers and New Treasure Bet Show Jumping Live competition coming up in just a few moments time here in the International Grass Arena. The winning round of the Bet Show Jumping Live competition coming up just a few moments time.
Pretty good. With me at the moment then. One of our sponsors from yesterday, but well known in the equestrian world, Deirdre Byrne. Deirdre, you must think this is a good idea.
This is a wonderful idea, because it's a completely different way of entertaining the people that are watching. To be able to have a little bet, and it encourages the riders to go that little bit quicker. So it's very entertaining.
So you see a good future for this?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I will definitely be attending.
So thank you very much, Dave, and as well, thank you very much for the sponsorship yesterday.
So that will have been good news, ladies and gentlemen. You may have remembered back at the beginning of our competition that we had a young lady to leave the arena after her horse looked to be in a bit of distress. Emily Turnton and Legend. We've just had some good news that only Jardine Evans, absolutely fine. There's nothing wrong with the horse. They'll be back out jumping in no time. So fantastic news there for Emily Turnton and Legend. Horse is absolutely fine. So we'll be underway in just a few moments' time. Just the final rolling going on in the with the tractor. They'll be out in just a couple of minutes' time. They're just on their way out now. And then we'll have the winning round. There is four coming forward for that winning round. I told you those four are 31, 14, 6 and 23. Once we've done that winning round, that will tell us who's getting the 10, the 5, the 3, the 2,000 euros. Following off from that, we have a bit of a treat here in the main international arena before we get on with the poissons. It is the horseman team from France. They'll be jumping at the same course our four are jumping off here, which incidentally is fences 1 to 11. It's the same course, exactly the same course as the first round. But the horseman team, they'll be coming in and they'll be trying to beat the time of the winner of our Special Living Live competition. It's going to be good. It's going to be fast. It's going to be furious. We'll be underway in just a couple of minutes in this special jumping live winning round here at Mullingar 2015. Gentlemen, here we are. It is the winning round of the Devonish Bed Show Jumping Live Competition. Four from each, the winner from each of our groups, four coming forward to contest the 10,000 euro first prize. Jumping first, 31, it is the winner from Group D, Jenna Clark, Zanzibar the fifth. He jumped a clear round, 63.16 was his time. He starts in this first position in the winning round. Jared Clark, 31, Santa Brother Fifth. Let's see here he goes. Last fence, 53, 54. It's clear, 57, 67 is the time of that. sets the standard in this winning round of the 10-minute special jumping live competition. Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Jeremy Clark, Zanzibar the 5th, 57.67 the time. So number 14 is going to be the next to join us in this winning round. They qualified from Group B. They'll be wearing the purple jersey. Number 14 is Frances Connors, Yuseki Diamond Lady. The Irish bred mare, consistent winner, jumps best off a good grass surface. Exactly what this arena is. Frances Connors, Yuseki Diamond Lady. They were 62.03 in their qualifying time, obviously, with active rounds from Group B. That's why he's got the purple jersey on. 14, Frances Connors, Yuseki Diamond Lady is our next to go. Of course, Frances Redenbaugh is one of the most experienced professionals, major player. Frances Connors, Yuseki Diamond Lady, 14. Okay, last fence, 48.49, good time. Yeah, he's done it, it's a clear round, Frances Connors, and your second down to me, 55.60 the time, and it's a clear round for Frances Connors, your second time to me, highly on the pressure for our next combination to jump. It is number 6, the only lady coming forward, qualifying from Group A, doing it for the ladies, Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle Forbesina, number 6. Well, 3 fences falling there, it's a total of 12 falls in this winning round for Nicola Fitzgibbon and 68.38 her time. But give her a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. She's still winning clear, she's still qualified for the winning round, and she's still going to go home with a very, very nice purse indeed. Well, we have one left to go. It is Kenneth Greer. Kenneth, 21 today. one of the country's top speed riders with extensive international experience. If any man can, this man can. He's 21 today. Will this be the best birthday ever? €10,000 says it will be. It is Kenneth Graham, Lenovo Donatella, 23. Oh, knocks the last fence all over the place. 12 faults there for Kenneth Graham, Lenovo Donatella, 62. 3-4 the time there. Puts him into the fourth position. So they will just confirm the results with our judges in this Devon Special Jumping Live competition. It has been absolutely fantastic. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Please stay the fantastic crowd all the way through. Please stay and give these riders the appreciation that they deserve. They've got a fantastic show for you. Please don't go anywhere. Presentations for the Devon Special Jumping Line competition coming up. So the final results of the Devon Special Jumping Live competition. It's a win for number 14, Frances Connors, Yuseki Diamond Lady. Taking second place is number 31, Jada Clark, Zanzibar the fifth. In third, number 6, Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle Fortina. And in fourth, Kenneth Graham, 23, Lenimore Donatella. Francis Connors, Jared Clark, Nicola Fitzgibbon and Kenneth Graham. That's the final four. We'll see them in just a second for our presentations. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Please stay and show your support. Also coming up afterwards, we have the horsemen from France. But don't go anywhere. Presentations are just around the corner. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very exciting event just about to happen. We thought it was all over. We thought it was finished. We thought we had a winner. But oh no, no, no. We have the horsemen from France, fresh from their competition in Shanghai. It is Marco, Anthony and Evan. Marco 25, Anthony only 18 years old, Evan 28 years old. Marco's from Italy, Anthony's from France, and Evan is also from France, and the world champion of jumping these heights. They have jumped up to 1.85 meters. Let's go. They're going to try and beat the time of Francis Connors, that being 55.60. Here we go. That's the bell to get us underway. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a clap as they go round. Marco is underway. So Marco on his way. Fences 1 and 2. He jumps at fence 3. He now sets off. Anthony's on his way. Give him a clap, ladies and gentlemen. It's a metaphorical look because we're outside. It's Anthony's on his way now. 18 years of age. They jump these heights. Huge fences built by our international course designer, Peter Gillespie. 6 A and B are clear. Anthony is on his way now. He jumps at fence 7. He then tags out to Evan. Here we go. It's the home run. Fence 8. Evan, 28 years of age, world champion. 1.85 meters. Hey, he's jumped up to it. This is absolutely the easiest thing he's ever done. But Kevin Murray. Cheers, then we come to the final line now. That's 10 to 11. Evan, horseman team from the France. And he's done it! And he's done it! 63-1-3! Oh, not quite fast enough to beat our winner, Francis Connors, in your second diamond lady. But Francis is happy about that because they were going to go at the 20,000 pounds of death. Well, this is a gentleman. Don't go anywhere, presentations are coming right up for our damage special jumping live competition. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please welcome to me now the winner of the Devonish Virtual Jumping Live competition. It is Francis Connors, your second diamond lady. Thank you. In second place, we have Jared Clark, Sansa by the fifth, third, Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle for Cena, and Kenneth Graham, Lenmore, Donatella. They take the fourth position. Congratulations to all four of them. They're going to line up in front of the marquee next to the Definition Nutrition fence for our official presentations. We thank you very much to Definition Nutrition for their sponsorship of this class. Thank you very much to PaddyPower.com for their help and support in the betting. And of course, thank you to the guys working in the cafe at the Tote station. And well done to indeed to all of our winners on the betting this afternoon. But we say a special well done, ladies and gentlemen, to our winner of the Devonis Bet Show Dumping Live Competition. It is Frances Connors, your second diamond lady, number 14, takes the win in the Bet Show Dumping Live Competition. Frances Connors. So Frances going home with that 10,000 euros. Fantastic prize here. Thank you very much to the team at Devonish and all involved in making this competition a success. Well supported on the ground. He's with Frances Connors right now. Wilson, how does Frances feel?
Frances, that's a big one to win.
That's a very, very exciting class. Extremely fast. Derek Clark had done a very fast round, so I was under pressure going in and had to give it a go.
It's a wonderful concept, leaving outside the money, isn't it?
It is. It's very exciting to watch because just even alone in the groups, it's good fun for everyone, you know, the winner of each group getting through, and I think it's a great concept.
It's, I'm looking at Joe Jumping out for a long time. It's a long time ago since I heard people shouting somebody come down to the last fence.
It is a long time, and I definitely heard him. I think the mayor did too.
Tell me about the bear.
She's 10-year-old now, and she's been very consistent for me. She's won quite a lot of Munster Grand Prix classes at level 135, and she's really consistent, very competitive.
Well done. We're thrilled for you, Frances. Congratulations. And say, if the Dacia produced anybody finer, they kept it to themselves. So good to have you with us. What can we say about the birthday man? My money, where, I'll get him to come to you first. Come in here to see you. Get a camera down here. That's just to get this camera down here, yeah. Kenneth, your mother is up there, she's stress tested, she's in the rehab, I think. Oh, because of that. Anyway, it's been a great show for you so far. You're in ribbons all the time.
Yeah, it's been good. I've had a good few seasons and no luck there in the last round, but the mare's gone great.
Yeah, no luck. What do you mean? You were in the last four.
No, oh, it's a brilliant result.
It's a great concept, isn't it?
It's great for the crowd and great class, yeah.
And the money's not bad either, a bit of a consideration.
Oh, it helps as well.
Anyway, well done and happy birthday. Jerry Clark, Jerry. He always seems to come up out of the way, doesn't he? You know, he never stays at home when it matters.
No, very happy with the horse. He's only started being jumping in speed now, maybe 6 weeks. And he's been placed in every one of them, so can't ask for any more.
You use this horse as a puissance horse?
Yeah, he's very good at the puissances. But, proven to be a very good jumping horse.
Very clean, isn't
he? He is, yeah, and he's quick.
He's quick, yeah. So, did you enjoy the class?
Yeah, it was very exciting.
It's great to be part of a good, as I say, not often you hear people shouting you come down to the last.
No, it seemed like we enjoyed it and everyone else did, so it's great.
Okay, well done. Nicola, I think you're only a thrill seeking there, we can't see you down here. Well, I'm asked the questions, not you.
I answer your questions.
It's a rhetorical, that's not rhetorical. Anyway, tell me, did you enjoy the class?
Oh, it was a great class, yeah. We're badly in need of new initiatives like this and show jumping to kind of make it a bit more interesting for the public. And I think you can see from the crowd today and the atmosphere that they really hit the mark with this class, so it was great.
So this is for the schedules for the future?
Pardon me?
This is for schedules for the future.
I really hope so. Certainly classes like this and similar sort of formats, you know, quick and interesting and fast and with lots of mishaps and good rounds.
It's been wonderful, and you've been a wonderful competition. Well done.
Yes, of course, well done to all four of our riders in the winning round. Each winner's in their own right, winning from each of their various group stages. I'd like to have the team from Devonish Treasure to present awards. And they present the awards to our first four, taking home the big money. Francis Connors, ladies and gentlemen, give him a round of applause. He takes away the 10,000 euros, Yusaki Diamond League. Francis Connors. They're also taking home that lovely rug. You can see Yusaki Diamond League sporting that very nicely. Of course, I'd have Kieran Connery of Devonish Nutrition presenting the awards in this competition. Ben Shaw, I mean, live the first of a kind. And remember, in years to come, when it's the Wayne Shaw of everything's done, remember, all standing here at Mullingar 2015. In second place, going to number 31, Jared Clark, Zanzibar in the fifth. Give him a round of applause. Shadow Clark, take second. In third place in the Devonish Nutrition Ventures opening live, it is Nicola Fitzgibbon, Castle Farms Tina, number 6, Nicola Fitzgibbon in third. And in fourth place, it is Kenneth Graham, 21 today. He rides Lennemore Donatella. Kenneth Graham takes the fourth place. And a 2,000 euro birthday present.
Kieran, we have to talk about Devonish because it's all right talking about the concept, but it takes somebody with the courage or a company with the courage and the foresight to come on board to make this happen. Kieran, can you tell me a bit about Devonish and maybe why you thought it was worth your while to come and do this?
Well, Devonish are delighted to be associated with this event. When Robert Fagan approached us last year about this innovative approach that gets both the crowd and the rider involved in the competition, we saw it as something new and innovative, and that's exactly what Devonish are about, innovation in animal nutrition, which is our core business. And we like to be associated with the horse industry and anything got to do with agriculture in this country.
You must be, well, how do you review it? I know it's early days, yes, so what would the debrief be?
Oh, we'd be delighted with this. Obviously, we look at all our sponsorships, but I can safely say that, you know, this is one for the future calendar, you know.
It's a wonderful atmosphere. Very seldom has ever been in show jumping, I say, nowadays, such an atmosphere as you have had here today, and not the most kindest of weather either.
Absolutely, and I think that's why the betting was an important part. It gets the crowd involved, and it's all the excitement with people who had €5 on or €10 on, and, you know, everybody got involved in the competition, not only the riders.
Well, Kieran, just going to say, from I know I can't speak on behalf of Mullingar, but on behalf of the wider community, we're thrilled to have you. Thank you very much indeed.
Well, of course, thank you very much to Devon and Succession for their support. Well, ladies and gentlemen, just before we send the Raiders off on their lap of honour, we're going to do two things. First of all, I'm going to speak to Robert Fagan, because I can see Wilson's very keen to do that. So, Wilson.
To say we've had talked to Kieran and who made it possible with through Devonish and all those who are here today, and believe me, everybody is so appreciative of what they've done. But it takes the courage and the foresight to make this start and to from a blank sheet and to start about it. Robert, what made you think about it, or how did it come about?
I suppose we all share the passion of show jump and we're always trying to think of new ideas, and I suppose the idea would be that to try and involve the general public and make it less, to simplify the whole thing. And as we've seen there today, it was very simple. The numbers on the back, and you didn't have to know the name of the rider or the horse. Or hopefully after a while you get familiar with those top riders, but just to simplify the whole thing and create plenty of fun. And as I say, we're very appreciative to Owen Brennan and the team there, of Simon and Kieran and also Pat McCartan and Jason Scarf. A lot of work went in over the last 9 months here to get this fruition, and hopefully it'll grow from here, and that it was great fun, and
it's seldom, I know I keep coming back to it, but the atmosphere, to hear people shouting and cheering on, I haven't heard that in a long time.
Yeah, sure, that's what it's all about. It's a bit of fun, and sure, everyone is meant to be able to have a good time. And I say we're a bit unfortunate with the weather, but still we're fortunate that we're able to keep going. And I say we're hopefully it's onwards and upwards from here.
Yeah, thank you very much, Robert. Sorry. Okay, Craig, if you want to get...
Well, thank you very much, Wilson and Robert. So just before we go over lap one, being with us just a second, we've got a couple of things to do. First of all, congratulations to St. Oliver Plunkett's Hurling Club. They were associated with the winning rider, Francis, in a draw organised by Mullingar International. So they win a €500 voucher, kindly supported by KC Sports, and well done to St. Oliver Plunkett's Hurling Club. Also, we have one more thing. Remember I mentioned earlier, the Style Stakes Takes a Turn competition. That's been organised by local fashion designer Andrea Cullen and owner of the Wardrobe Boutique Mullingar. The winner is local lady Melanie Lynch, and she is presented with a €100 voucher for the Wardrobe Boutique of Mullingar. So thank you very much to Andrea Cullen and her team of the Wardrobe Boutique for the Style Stakes Takes a Turn competition. Congratulations to them. They are just next to the winning cabin. So thank you very much to everybody who's put forward prizes, to all the betting, to everyone who's made a success. It's finally lap of our time. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been fantastic. Francis Connors, Jerry Clark, Nicola Fitzgibbon, Kenneth Graham, putting hands together, the four winners of the Devonish Special Living Live Competition. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, it's on the winner. €10,000 prize money. It is Francis Connors, Yusaki Diamond Lady, one of the Devonish Succession Bet Show Jumping Live Competition.
Stand up for the champions, for the champions. Stand up, stand up, stand up for the champions, for the champions. Stand up for the champions, for the champions. Stand up, stand up, stand up for the champions, for the champions. Stand up. Getting close, now it's just 2-1-6.
ladies and gentlemen, Frances Connors, Yosaki Diamond Lady, winners of the Devilish Pressure Dumping Live competition. Well, if that wasn't enough for you, ladies and gentlemen, we have probably to date the most, certainly the highest in height and the most exciting show jumping competition that has been known to date. It is, of course, the Puissance, and in this particular case, it is the Puissance qualifier for the Royal Dublin Show. That coming up in round about 20 minutes or so, and here in the International Glacier, you can see the arena party quickly moving into action to assemble the big red ball, headed up by our international coach trainer, Peter Gillespie. So that's coming up right about 20 minutes time. It is the Royal Dublin Show qualifier for the Puissance here at Mullingar International Hot Show. We'll be back in around about 20 minutes time. 20 minutes.